Hello everyone, my name is Udo Blessing, and today I just want to show you some little tricks you can use to make a nice background. Today we'll be doing landscape, and it's very, very interesting because I just discovered the use of the knife tool, and it just made the work easier. Let's just go right into the tutorial. First, I would like you to just create a rectangle to represent the letter M for the shortcut, then drag across the artboard. I'm using document size of 1920 by 1080. Okay, I have my rectangle set up. Let me just use a custom color. I think this is okay. All right, this is where the trick comes. Then you come to where you have the eraser tool, then you click on weight, and you choose the knife tool. So the knife tool helps you to cut custom shapes from a particular vector. Now all you need to do is just select the vector you want to cut from, then you start from outside the vector, then you cut. Now I'm cutting a mountain shape sort of from it. Okay, now it is set up. So this is all just you don't need. You can just have a background mountain at the back, just to depict a mountainous region sort of. Okay, we're following that. So when you're done with that, you've successfully set up your mountainous region. All you just need to do is just to begin to add color just to beautify it. Actually, basically, this is what I want to show you. Let's just add color and see how beautiful it can go. Now, let me leave this one as this is. We are depicting a night scene. Okay, so if there is a moon, that means there should be like an highlight on the mountain. So let me change the color so that I can be visible. I'll change it back. So this is how I created my highlight. I took my direct selection tool, then I clicked on control on shift, and I deselected this point. Now if I copy this vector, only the selected part will show. Now this is how I will do it. Control F. Now I've been able to have another portion selected. All you need to do is just scale it down a little bit. Scale it up a little bit. Then you change the color to something like orange color. That's to depict a light. Now all you need to do, then after when you're done with that, drag this one up and drag this one up. Drag it till it covers the mountainous region you're trying to depict it as light. When you are done with that, just arrange until it covers to some extent. There is this space here, but it does not matter. Then after you are done with this, all you need to do again is to click on this mountainous region and have a copy of it, Control F. This copy is to mask out this highlight. The copy is to mask out the highlight. Now when you come to the layer panel, you see this is one mountainous region, this is another mountain, but this one will be masked. So it will be a mask for the highlight. Then you shift it up above the highlight, you select the highlight also, then you press Control 7. So that is to mask out the highlight. I'll give you a tutorial on masking. Just check my channel and you will see a tutorial on how to mask. You understand better what I did there, and also you check the tutorial on how to use the knife too. It's there for you to enjoy. Now when you are done with this, let me just add a little highlight to the mountain at the back, just to differentiate it a little bit. Okay, now we are getting there. Then this one at the back here, this is like the sky. So the sky in the night would have like a something like a red to dark red gradient. A red to dark red gradient. I think that should be something it should have. So just pick something like a red to a dark red gradient. Okay, then it should be top to bottom. The black should be top, the red should be bottom. Change this to 90 if you want to make it top to bottom. It should be top to bottom in this manner, like this. Make this a little darker since we are depicting the night. It is a little darker. To darker, or depicting night. So find a way to make it a little bit darker. Okay, I think this is too much. The difference should just be okay, something like that. Okay. I want to cover up the. Okay, so you have something set up like this. Let us just make the sun. The sun too should have something like an orangey kind of color. Make it a little bit orange, sort of. And it should be radial. Drag the slider up. Orange to red, that's for the sun. Do it in a way that it blend with the scene. Remove the stroke. Okay, and you're done with that. Another effect you can give to the sun is duplicating it and expanding it. That's Control F, then expand, put it to the back.